COVID cruise ship problems have returned to Melbourne with five infected passengers taken to hospital. They arrived on the Grand Princess this morning after it was turned away from Newcastle.
A cruise ship passenger in need of priority medical care. A fleet of ambulances was dispatched to greet the Grand Princess after it docked at Station Pier. Of the 2,000 passengers, it's believed at least 180 are COVID positive. John Thompson's wife among them.
Yeah, she got COVID on the last day, so she's been confined to her room yesterday. We believe there's quite a few, but we don't know how many because everybody gets confined to their room.
We know of people who are kept in their room, obviously, but they were fed and watered.
Six passengers were treated by paramedics, five were hospitalised. They include two women aged in their 80s. All patients were in stable conditions.
Ultimately, we're there to provide support and care to people who need it, and there'll be a mixture of people who that's the safest way for them to be transported.
Bus drivers in full PPE transported some of the COVID-positive passengers, others relying on taxis, friends and family. Cruise operators say it's business as usual for them, despite the COVID precautions in place.
COVID-wise was really good. They were very careful in the food areas, very careful around the ship. We had to keep these on all the time, unless we were eating.
All passengers and crew are required to test negative to COVID before boarding, with the ship enforcing a 95% vaccination rate.
And Cameron Bowe joins us now. Cameron, the next destination for the Grand Princess will be New Zealand.
Mitch, more than 2,000 passengers are about to embark on a 13-day round trip. The crew will need to provide daily updates to Health New Zealand on COVID cases. Anyone who tests positive will need to isolate for 7 days, a fair chunk of the trip, Mitch.
Cameron Bowe at Port Melbourne, thank you.